The Ukrainian military is now taking anti-drone tech advice from teenagers. Seriously. 4 years into a brutal war, as both sides race to out-engineer each other on the battlefield, one of Ukraine's most promising new weapons against Russian drones didn't come from a defense contractor or NATO lab. It came from an 18-year-old gamer in Kyiv. Armed with nothing but YouTube tutorials, a 3D printer, and a shot at revenge, he built something shockingly effective. A cheap, net-firing shotgun round that can take down Russian FPV drones, and it's already saving lives on the front line. It sounds absurd, but in Ukraine's war for survival, this is innovation, and this teenager may have just outsmarted a billion-dollar arms race. Let's take a closer look at how the war's most unlikely weapons developer is reshaping the battlefield, and what it says about the future of warfare. Innovation has naturally emanated from Ukraine's established defense industry, which has revolutionized warfare with the development of numerous airborne and naval drones. But sometimes it evolves on the battlefield itself, as soldiers come up with ingenious and often improvised solutions, like covering transit routes and entrances to strongholds and trenches with fishing nets to protect them from drone attacks, as Russia tries to play catch-up. Overall, it's hard to overstate just how important anti-drone measures have become in the war in Ukraine. When Russia launched its full-scale invasion in February 2022, it did so in a well-established manner, with columns of tanks and armored vehicles rumbling forward, backed with artillery and support from fighter jets and bombers. The Ukrainian army squared off with them with much the same array of weaponry, but they had already started pioneering the use of drones in the attack. Sure, high-end surveillance drones like the RQ-4 Global Hawk, attack drones like the US's MQ-9 Reaper, and loitering munitions like the Turkish Bayraktar were already an established component of the modern arsenal before 2022. But the widespread use of inexpensive FPV and larger kamikaze drones, both on the battlefield and for attacks in the rear, wasn't really a big deal in warfare yet. Fast forward 3.5 years, and it's rare to find either side charging into battle with brigades of tanks and other armor. Even the most advanced tanks in use in Ukraine, Russia's T-90M and the US-supplied M1 Abrams, have proven far from impervious to disabling attacks from even the most lightweight of FPV drones. The Kyiv Independent quotes NATO sources as saying more than 60% of Russia's staggering tank losses are estimated to have been inflicted by FPV drones. The number is similar, if not greater, when it comes to casualties. Drones are also reported to be responsible for 60-70% of Ukraine's battlefield casualties, according to medics. Soldiers on both sides are in constant danger, even up to 20 miles from the contact line. Packs of inexpensive kamikaze FPV drones hunt virtually every type of target. Bunkers, fortified positions in tree lines, armored vehicles, and infantry units, if they're visible, they're targets. Initially, Ukraine held a clear advantage over Russia in terms of drone production and deployment. Indeed, facing a roughly threefold disadvantage in manpower and heavy weaponry compared to Russia, Ukraine embraced the use of unmanned weaponry as an area in which it could achieve a decisive strategic advantage. In 2024, Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky said the country produced approximately 2.2 million drones, and used even more, greatly reducing the pace of Russian advances and inflicting huge losses as a result. However, over time, Russia's much greater industrial capacity has gradually caught up. Much of Ukraine's drone manufacturing industry is decentralized and relies heavily on ingenuity and resilience. FPV drones are put together in hundreds of workshops in apartments, warehouses, and basements throughout the country. It's not uncommon to find assembly workshops, complete with a 3D printer, in Ukrainian positions right on the front lines. By contrast, Russia's giant factory in Alabuga, Tatarstan, is now reportedly able to produce up to 5,000 of the heavy Garand or Shahed loitering munitions that plague Ukraine nightly per month. That's despite being directly hit by Ukrainian long-range drones at least 5 times since 2024. In addition, the Russians have a significant lead in fiber-optic FPV drones, which are guided by and connected to miles of ultra-thin fiber-optic cable instead of the usual GPS. This immunizes them against jamming and other electronic warfare techniques deployed against them. As a result, for Ukraine, anti-drone defenses have become an increasingly critical priority. Two main areas need to be addressed, and more or less constantly. It's a cat-and-mouse game of drone and anti-drone production between the two sides. Sometimes there are only weeks between the time that one side develops a successful countermeasure and the other side develops a countermeasure to that countermeasure. The first is countering Russia's nightly drone swarms that target Ukrainian cities and infrastructure all over the country, far behind the front lines. Reflecting Russia's growing production capacity, these swarms have swelled in number during the summer of 2025 to between 150 and 700 per night. Ukraine consistently reports bringing down north of 90% of these drones, which are typically the Russian-made Garand 2 and Garand 3 analogs of the infamous Iranian Shahed 136. That stands to reason. Garands are relatively slow and noisy, and thus easy to identify, track, and engage. The Garand 2 has a maximum speed of about 112 miles per hour, while the turbojet engine-powered Garand 3 reportedly reaches speeds of up to 550 or 600 kilometers per hour, depending on whether you believe Ukrainian or Russian assessments. As for their sonic signature, they're not known as flying lawnmowers for nothing. At those speeds, they're easily targeted by Ukraine's advanced MiM-104 Patriot, IRIS-T-SLM and NASAMS air defense systems, or indeed the AIM-9L Sidewinder and AIM-120 AMRAAM air-to-air missiles, with which its F-16s are equipped. However, it's simply not cost-effective or sustainable to use these systems to shoot down drones. Russian Garands are estimated to cost between $30,000 and $100,000 each, depending on the model and payload. In contrast, a single Patriot missile can cost between $4 and $7 million. IRIS-TSLM and SLS missiles cost around $630,000 and $470,000 respectively, and a single AMRAAM missile, which is used by NASAMS, costs more than $1.2 million. True, allowing the drones to strike their targets runs the risk of incurring damage worth far more than the cost of firing an interceptor missile or two at them. But on a simple cost-benefit analysis, it's hard to justify the expense, especially when you consider that inventories of all these missiles are not abundant, demand for them worldwide is high, and the manufacturers can only produce up to 600 of each in total annually. Ukraine could use them all up in weeks. To make matters worse, up to 40% of the drones used in Russia's drone swarms are actually decoys, with a similar signature to Garands but without any explosive payload. They're designed specifically to exhaust expensive air defense interceptors, paving the way for real Garands with heavy payloads to follow in their wake. Now, if Ukraine is in a position where it can only use its high-tech guaranteed drone killers sparingly at best to defend its cities and critical infrastructure, imagine the situation on the front lines. Using a $500,000 missile to shoot down a drone worth only 10 to 20% as much is unfeasible. Using the same missile to shoot down an FPV or a simple surveillance drone worth 10 times less than even that is simply out of the question. That's the second area in which anti-drone systems have become a critical requirement for the Ukrainian armed forces: anti-FPV and surveillance drone systems for use on the battlefield. And that's where the subject of our story, an 18-year-old Kyivite named Yuri, comes in. Ukraine's first line of defense against FPV drones, and indeed Garands, is electronic warfare, or EW. These systems counter drones by disrupting their critical electronic signals, primarily through jamming and spoofing. They detect enemy drone signals, analyze their frequency, and then emit powerful interference on the same frequencies to sever communication, disable navigation, and/or force the drone to return or crash. Ukraine has significant EW assets, including thousands of Lithuanian Skywiper electronic drone mitigation 4 and Omni systems, and dead drones, dead drone portable sensors, and drone defenders radio frequency jammers. At least 300 of these sensors have been installed along the front line, each capable of identifying and detecting the radio signatures of nearly 600 different models of drones at range. However, these systems are largely ineffective against Russia's fiber-optic drones, which don't emit jammable or spoofable signals, and against drones flying at altitudes above their effective range. The next line of defense is currently proving to be one of the most effective: good old-fashioned bullets. That said, some of the bullets Ukraine is firing at Russian drones, and the systems that are firing them, are anything but old-fashioned. Most of the bullets are being fired at short-range targets from machine guns and autocannons of various shapes and sizes. The UK-supplied MSIDS Terrorhawk Paladin system, for example, uses a 30mm Mark 44 Bushmaster II autocannon to engage targets up to 1.86 miles away, using XM1211 high-explosive proximity-fused ammunition. The 160 Slinger systems supplied to Ukraine by Australia use a Bushmaster M230LF 30x113mm cannon with similar rounds to the Paladin to automatically track and eliminate moving targets beyond half a mile away. Ukraine has recently received deliveries of two prototypes of state-of-the-art Wolf 25 anti-drone systems. The Wolf 25AD has a remotely operated Mangart 25 turret with a 25mm Oerlikon KBA automatic cannon and an 8-barrel smoke grenade launcher for deploying smoke screens. The weapon can fire airburst rounds, conventional high-explosive shells, and armor-piercing ammunition. It has four Rheinmetall radars for target detection, which provide full 360-degree coverage, enabling detection of Lancet drones 5 to 6 miles away, and reconnaissance UAVs and small quadcopters like FPV drones up to 3 miles away. Ukraine is also firing bullets at drones from the air, and rather effectively at that. According to Armed Forces Commander-in-Chief Oleksandr Sirsky, helicopter crews have become a critical part of the country's layered air defense system. In late September, he said that Ukraine is increasing the deployment of helicopters in air defense missions after commanders reported their effectiveness in intercepting Russian long-range drones. Depending on the weather, our helicopters sometimes shoot down up to 40% of drones in their sectors. That's why we're scaling up in this direction as well, he told a media briefing. The tactic involves pairing two helicopters with complementary roles, one equipped with weapons to directly engage drones, and the other fitted with advanced sensors. The sensor-equipped aircraft, often carrying the Teledyne FLIR multi-sensor system, guides the armed helicopter to its target, a method that has proven highly effective against drones carrying warheads of up to 200 pounds. However, the least old-fashioned and arguably most effective anti-drone gun that Ukraine has is the Sky Sentinel system, developed by Ukraine itself. Sky Sentinel is an autonomous, AI-controlled air defense turret equipped with a heavy machine gun that's capable of 360-degree rotation. It can comfortably strike a Garand or even a drone up to 5 times smaller. Its ability to strike small, fast-moving targets traveling at speeds of 125, 250, or even 500 miles per hour has earned it the nickname Shahid Catcher. But anything that flies into its range, recon drones, loitering munitions, cruise missiles, or whatever, is fair game. Sky Sentinel will deal with the threat all by itself. Simply deploy the Sky Sentinel into a combat position, feed it radar data, and it detects, locks on, tracks the flight paths, calculates the shot, and upon remote human authorization, fires completely autonomously. Although its maximum engagement range remains classified, Sky Sentinel is versatile enough to defend both urban centers and high-risk frontline zones under constant drone attack. Each unit costs around $150,000, although it uses standard machine gun rounds, so the ammunition costs are comparatively very cheap. However, the implementation of the system is in its infancy, and effectively protecting a single city will likely require 10 to 30 turrets per city. So it's going to be a while before the poor grunts in the trenches on the front lines risking their lives every time they pop out to empty their bladders benefit from Sky Sentinel's protection. In many cases, they're left shooting at drones with bog-standard machine guns, infantry rifles, and shotguns. But this is exactly where Yuri's invention can make a huge difference to Ukraine's frontline forces. It's a low-cost, highly effective anti-drone net round that can be fired from a simple shotgun. Yuri's journey into the world of anti-drone warfare began in 2023 as an 11th grader in Kyiv's semi-industrial, semi-residential Shulyavka district. The neighborhood saw heavy fighting at the very beginning of Russia's full-scale invasion, particularly near the Kyiv Zoo, and has been subject to numerous drone and missile attacks since. Frustrated with school, immersed in YouTube videos about military equipment, DIY engineering, and 3D printing, and too young to enlist in the armed forces, he searched for another way to contribute. In his words, "The motivation was to bring benefit to the country. School was moving too slowly, my neighborhood was being bombed, and I wanted to do something useful." His first idea was for a quieter FPV drone propeller. He pitched it to the Defense Tech Incubator, but when the pitch failed, he pivoted to anti-drone munitions. "On the battlefield, 75% of injuries now come from drones," he says. "Drones could be the biggest threat to individuals in the coming years. Creating anti-drone systems can truly save lives." The light bulb went on in Yuri's head while he was playing a first-person shooter video game with a friend who knew a bit about ammunition. "It was during those gamers' discussions that the idea of anti-drone net rounds for a grenade launcher came to me," he said. He and his partner began building a prototype. They first pitched it to the Presidential Brigade, where a soldier looked at it and said, "Oh cool, a grenade launcher anti-drone munition." They left him a sample, but in the end, the unit couldn't help because it lacked testing procedures. However, they didn't have to wait long before they got a serious bite from the legendary 3rd Assault Brigade. The 3rd Assault Brigade is renowned for innovative drone use. For example, in the summer of 2025, it carried out the first prisoner capture in history conducted solely with aerial and ground drones. The officer examining the prototype was stunned to hear that Yuri and his team were still at school. "What kind of children in the world can make ammunition? Ukrainian children, of course," he exclaimed. He asked what they needed to run initial tests and promised to get back to them in a few weeks. The officer was good to his word. A few weeks later, Yuri's team was invited to a training center to test the prototype and, crucially, to attach the explosive charge. Handling explosives in Ukraine is strictly regulated, all the more so during wartime. Under Article 263 of the Criminal Code, violations carry prison sentences, and being a minor makes it impossible to obtain any authorization. After the first tests, the officer said, "Okay guys, this is cool, but in our brigade there are more shotguns than grenade launchers, so make us the same thing for shotguns." Within days, Yuri and his team had switched calibers and delivered the first samples, and 2 weeks later, they received a message from the officer. "It works!" Soon after, he ordered 100 units for real combat testing. According to Yuri, this speed in decision-making is both a strength and a weakness when it comes to Ukraine's wartime technological industries. "We have a lot of private companies appearing, and they move faster than state enterprises," Yuri said. "But there is no system for everything to quickly move from a startup to the army. Because of this, many things remain prototypes." As a result, Yuri and his friends weren't expecting that first order. They hadn't thought about scaling up production and the problems they might encounter. Watching a training video from the 3rd Assault Brigade, they recognized their munition being tested. The round jammed and the instructor joked, "Now I'm going to die because it didn't fire." It made a huge impression on Yuri. At that moment, I was really scared because I realized if something goes wrong, a person could be killed. Fortunately, he was about to receive feedback of a far more reassuring nature. A special forces unit called from the Kursk front saying, "We tested your stuff. It was awesome." The caller said that his unit had used Yuri's shotgun rounds to successfully take down a Mavic reconnaissance drone at 165 feet and two Russian FPV drones. That was when Yuri knew his idea worked and had already saved lives. Since then, the enterprising teen has followed the path of a typical startup: programming, testing, business development, and searching for partners. He is waiting for a grant decision from Brave One, Ukraine's primary defense tech cluster. As it happens, Brave One is already active in the same area as Yuri, namely low-cost anti-drone ammunition, primarily meant for frontline use. In late June, Brave One introduced a different kind of anti-drone ammunition designed for standard infantry rifles. The rounds, which resemble regular 5.45mm cartridges, are designed to fragment mid-air, increasing the chances of hitting fast-moving FPV drones. After being fired, the round breaks apart into approximately 5 fast-moving pellets. When multiple rounds are fired in rapid succession, they produce a shotgun-like spread that can effectively engage drones at ranges of up to 165 feet. Already codified for use, the ammo is being distributed to frontline soldiers, with one magazine to each soldier. They're as easy to load as any other magazine. Brave One also lists a portable electronic warfare device known as the anti-drone pistol on its market platform that is designed to counter hostile FPV drones. The device is marketed as a personal protection tool for soldiers and uses radio frequency interference to disrupt the control channels of enemy drones. Weighing just 2.2 pounds, it's light and portable enough to carry anywhere and has a jamming range of over 300 feet. Meanwhile, although not developed under the wings of Brave One, Yuri does face some more direct competition from Ukrainian defense company Teneta, the Mitler net launcher. It's a lightweight, single-use anti-drone device designed to counter enemy FPV drones and reconnaissance quadcopters with a rapidly deploying entanglement net. Weighing less than 13 ounces, the Mitler launcher measures just 7.8 inches in height and 1.6 inches in diameter, meaning it's easy to store in a pouch, backpack, or uniform pocket. The system operates manually and requires no external power or setup. To activate it, the user simply aims and fires, releasing a net that entangles the drone's rotors mid-flight. The net itself measures 11.5 by 11.5 feet, with an effective range of up to 82 feet. A 7.62 mm pyrotechnic cartridge provides the propulsion for the net. According to the developers, these specifications allow the device to disrupt drone flight paths during close-range combat or while defending fortified positions. In the long run, due to its adaptability and the fact that it's loaded into the ubiquitous shotgun, Yuri's net round is likely to become more widely adopted on the front lines than the Mitler. Nonetheless, both inventions and others we've covered in this video highlight both the relentless military innovation and the resilient spirit of the Ukrainian people. As for Yuri, he's an adult now and torn between continuing his studies, devoting himself fully to his startup, or joining the army. For now, he combines all three, following some classes on his phone while testing his ammunition at military bases and taking part in Centuria, the youth paramilitary camp run by the 3rd Assault Brigade. His generation is growing up in wartime, and some, like Yuri, refuse to stay on the sidelines. "I'm not afraid to die, but I want to be useful first," he says. Make sure to subscribe to the channel and enable notifications to learn about the latest military innovations in Ukraine and around the world. And thank you for watching.